At this point, many of you have probably heard about EAGate, which is the scandal involving FIFA Ultimate Team and how EA accounts were exploited in such a way that it is suspected EA employees might have used those accounts to essentially give out, or rather than give out, it's more like they were selling them for hundreds to thousands of dollars, and there were people willing to pay for those because actually getting those cards legitimately through FIFA Ultimate Team was just so much worse as an option. You'd have to spend hundreds, thousands more. And what this is all ultimately highlighted is how truly broken and how truly unfair FIFA Ultimate Team is, which is what makes it so hypocritical that in EA's response to players pointing out this EAGate scandal, they say things like the alleged behavior is unacceptable, it goes counter to the game's competitive integrity, it would create an unequal playing field for our community, this activity is unacceptable, we know that the trust of our communities is hard-earned and is based on principles of fair play, this is a breach of that principle as well, and we won't let it stand. EA actually had the audacity to spout words like this when they themselves engage in unacceptable behavior, unacceptable activity, in things that go counter to the game's competitive integrity. FIFA Ultimate Team was designed to be counter to competitive integrity. It was designed in such a way that it will create an unequal playing field for their community because people who pay straight up just gain an advantage because it's a pay-to-win game with loot box, slot machine, gambling elements. EA is about the last company that has any right to talk about fair play when they're the ones causing these problems through the way they're monetizing. The EAGate scandal has made enough ripples and it has highlighted the unfairness of FIFA enough that people have gone out of their way to do some math and they came up with numbers that really highlight how atrocious your progression options are, and just how stacked against you the cards are in this game. So this is Twitter user Scuds TV, and let's just read this out. Let's talk about EA's FIFA 21. You claim that everyone can get all players they desire without spending money on the game. This is indeed something EA keeps touting to sell you the illusion that the microtransactions and loot boxes are optional. But they're not. If you don't pay up, you're straight up just going to have a far worse experience than everyone else. You're going to be at a disadvantage. Here's my dream team. You can see right here, it's basically fully comprised of these icon cards that are extremely rare. And according to this individual, this team right here accounts for roughly 100 million coins. That's how much this team right here is worth when you take into account their price in the marketplace in relation to their rarity. So 100 million FIFA coins is the key number here. And scrolling down, Scuds TV breaks it down further by just playing the game versus monitoring the market versus spending money to earn 100 million coins. And the results really highlight how exploitative this game is. So as far as earning cards just through gameplay, trying to earn 100 million coins just through gameplay, here's what Scuds TV had to say. Assuming an average of 1,500 coins a game, accounting for weekly rewards, that's a mere 66,666 games. At an average of 20 minutes a game, that's a mere 22,000 hours of gameplay or 916 days of gameplay 24/7. 916 days, for those who don't know, is roughly 2.5 years. In this scenario presented by Scuds TV, to build this dream team full of icon cards, you would need to play FIFA for 2.5 years straight with no breaks for the possibility of achieving this. Think about that for a second. What makes matters worse is that FIFA is an annualized franchise, and that means that with every new entry, they have a 1 year long expiration date. And yet the game expects you to play for 2.5 years straight just so you can build a team of this magnitude. Even if you were somehow superhuman and could play this game straight without any breaks whatsoever, you would not have nearly enough time to create a team like this before the game's year-long expiration date runs out and the next entry releases. EA keeps touting that the microtransactions and loot boxes are optional, but are they really? when not paying extra money will mean that you'll have to spend years straight just to accrue a dream team. And let me emphasize that this is the best case scenario. These averages are generous. For most people who don't have time to treat FIFA like it's their part-time job or hell, full-time job and spend hours on it every day, the results are going to be far worse. Now, here's method two, monitoring the marketplace. Here's how much you have to struggle to earn your dream team through this method. Assuming an average of 10,000 coins profit per trade, which again is generous, I need to make a mere 10,000 trades. Yeah, if you're pursuing this route, the game for you essentially becomes a marketplace simulator rather than a soccer slash football simulator. Assuming I trade 10,000 every 10 minutes, I will need to trade for 1,650 hours or 69 days of trading 24/7. Even if you get really good, it would take you about over 2 months of straight gameplay to achieve 100 million coins and be able to build this specific dream team. Is it better than 2.5 years straight? Sure. But that's like saying diarrhea is better than radiation. It's just, they're both awful. And not everyone wants to engage with the market. Some people just want to play the game of soccer that FIFA should be. But FIFA, of course, is more of a marketplace slash casino simulation. Last but not least, the third method, the method that EA wants you to engage in, spending money, in this case, pounds. Here's how much money you have to spend to build your dream team. Assuming an average of 100,000 coins profit per 12,000 FIFA points spent, I need to purchase 1,000 12,000 FIFA points. And again, this feels like a generous average. At a cost of 80 pounds per 12,000 coins, I need to spend a total of almost 80,000 pounds on FIFA points. 80,000 pounds is the price of this team. Oh, and do you want to know how 80,000 pounds translates into dollars? We're looking at $111,428.32 that you would need to spend if you want a team like this, a team of this caliber. The alternative is that you will have to grind for years. The alternative is the impossibility of building a team like this within the time frame given, a year. Scuds TV put it best in follow-up tweets. You need to understand the options you put in front of your community do not allow everyone to achieve whatever they desire in your game within reasonable limits. People have lives. Not everyone can engage with trading, and certainly nobody can grind for 2.5 years 24/7 and achieve that kind of goal. It's just not possible. It's just not realistic. It is possible technically, but it's far from realistic, and EA 100% knows this. But this technically allows them to tout optional because it's technically possible if you really, really work hard for 2.5 years straight. But that might as well be as good as impossible within, again, the year-long life cycle of a FIFA entry. You have put the high-end content behind an extreme paywall or an unachievable time wall. The stance you take is unethical. You are, one, encouraging your community to spend huge amounts of time playing your game at the detriment to mental health, or two, encouraging your community to spend, for most, an unethical amount of money at the detriment to financial health. They basically give you one of two options. Do you want to waste your time, or do you want to waste your money? Now, of course, there are those mega rich people for whom tens of thousands of dollars is basically pocket change. They're not going to see this as an issue, but most people who buy FIFA are your average Joes who make an average wage and salary. They cannot afford to spend over $100,000 on player cards just to build their dream team. It's just an unattainable goal for the masses. And so obviously that gives the rich, or people who are so addicted that they're spending all their money on FIFA, a huge advantage in the game. There is literally a class divide within FIFA, especially because these cards aren't just cosmetic, they're straight up pay to win. Scutz TV's string of tweets concludes with this: if profits are your aim, then congratulations, you win, and do continue the way you are. Actually, please don't. However, if compassion to your community and running a game that offers a fair playing field for the best is your aim, then you are failing miserably. Shame on you, EA Sports FIFA. Indeed, if you are pursuing a level competitive playing field, if you're pursuing integrity, if you're pursuing principles of fair play, you're about as opposite end of the spectrum as you can get, EA. But they know this, and they don't care, because at the end of it all, the one lord they serve is money, and they're raking it in. Now, you can see right here, based on the 20,000 likes, that this series of tweets kind of went viral, and we're already seeing headlines from various media outlets, and we're seeing some people even construct a chart showing how long and how much money it would take to get individual player cards, individual icon cards, and the numbers are equally abhorrent. There is not much else for me to say here. This all really speaks for itself, and if government bodies are seeking to regulate companies like EA and greedy practices like FIFA Ultimate Team, then I highly recommend that they take a look at Scuds TV's calculations and do their own investigations so that they can see just how bad that less than 1% probability of obtaining some of the rarest rewards, just how bad that really is. There is nothing fair or ethical about FIFA, about Ultimate Team, about the way they label this as a game for kids, the way they keep touting that it's not gambling. They're full of shit. They're greedy and straight up evil for being complacent to this, and despite complaints just dating back years and years and years, EA continues to engage like this while pretending like they're all about fair play. They can go fuck themselves. But that's just one man's sentiments. Let me know in the comments below what your take is on the information that Scuds TV relate here about the amount of time and money you have to spend in order to accrue your dream team. Drop a comment, and to be further updated on all things gaming news, reviews, and discussions, stay tuned right here on Yong Yeah. I'll see you guys next time. Yong out.